What do you do and why?
I'm Somijah Archer. I go by Sumo the Artist. I'm a local artist. I'm a painter, entrepreneur, business owner. I have my own custom art business called This Is Intentional, and I paint anything that I can physically see.
Why?
Yeah, it's very therapeutic. And then painting, for me, it's more so about the outcome of what I'm going to create. Because I'm always more so thinking about, like, the person I'm doing it for. That's mostly what's on my mind. So I paint to make sure, like, because I specialize in custom work, I paint to make sure whatever I'm doing is so custom that it's like somebody else is going to love it just as much as I do.
This shoot today, it's a bunch of editorial vibes. We got OG Key in the cuts and all these beautiful models. We got the OG QP shooting. He a goat. Also, this shoot is, nobody know this but you, I think. This shoot gonna be a part of my portfolio. I'm about to submit these pictures. Y'all gonna be in my portfolio. You're here, man. Whoa. I'm gonna submit these pictures for this artist residency I'm trying to get into. So, hope we get in, y'all. Ooh, live. 2020, yeah.
I think she actually loves what she does. She not doing it for money or like clout or whatever. She gets up every morning and does this. Like, you could tell she put her soul into this every single day.
Like, it's literally into, like, there's nothing that she doesn't touch that doesn't have paint on it. So you can tell, like, it's intentional. She does it with fun. Like, it's fun to her. So you can tell it's love in it. Like, that's
cool. Because we went to a high school where you didn't have to wear uniforms. And so I used to paint on my clothes so they would look different. So I wasn't wearing the same stuff to school every day. And then people started asking me where I got it and all that kind of stuff. This is intentional. I don't even know if it really came from somewhere. Subconsciously, it was called Painting with a Purpose at one time. Because I actually went to this like clay class and made a cup, and it said painting with a purpose. And I didn't realize until I was older that I had did that. And I'm like, But I think it became This Is Intentional in high school just because I realized everything I do is intentional, and it's like, it's super like on purpose all the time. Every mess up, every cute thing, ugly thing, it's all intentional. I really love Jackson Pollock just because his style of art is like the more so splattery of what I'm into. I actually studied him a lot when I was in college before I dropped out. But I studied him a lot, and so he was really inspiration for me because like studying the pattern of his splatters, it helped me because like I actually have different types of splatters and all that kind of stuff. Every piece of anything I give anybody, period. Every single piece of whatever gets saged. Gotta, cause I'm not finna give you something and like the energy on it wacky hell. I'm not with it. Like if you're gonna wear it, you gotta be intentional about it and you gotta feel comfortable in it enough to where you wearing it and it's like, I'm wearing a piece of myself basically. Do you have like a fish nature?
My first ever show was I did in high school. My friend Marnisha, shout out to Marnisha. She had a show we did in high school. It was called Recycle Runway. She did a closing drive with like local high schools, and all the pieces that we got, we like I painted some of them for that show. I did revamped them and stuff like that. That was my first show I ever did. I think that was in 2016 or 15. And since then, I really don't know. When I went to go to U of M, I probably have done a lot of shows, because they do a lot of fashion shows up on campus. I had my own show last year. It was called the Tsunami Effect. I did it at Branson. That was really, really amazing. And then this year so far, I might have done maybe two. I think it's Memphis right now is really big on street fashion. Because then street fashion is also comfort. Because most people that wear street fashion, you think like oversized wear, you know, stuff that you're comfortable in, you can flex in, and you can be fresh and stuff like this. There's only so much you can do in Memphis, because this is not an art-based city. This is not an art-high city, you know. It's like Memphis is slowly trying to become it, but if it came to like my big break one day, like I'm going, like there's nothing that's gonna hold me back. If somebody asked me to do a show in another state in 2 days, like I would go. So I'm real big on like taking opportunities, because I'm not going to know what I'm going to get out of it unless I do. I try to remain stress-free, because I feel like I'm doing what I love. I shouldn't be stressed about it. Like, you know, there's always stressful aspects to things, but I just try to make sure I don't let them overwhelm me. If I get overwhelmed, I'll probably just... Like, if it's like days preparation for a show and I get overwhelmed, I just like take a whole day to be like, I'm not painting nothing, I'm not touching nothing, I'm just gonna breathe.
Okay, so a lot of people. You know,
if I'm in a mood to where I don't want to paint, or it's usually a reason why behind I won't, but if it's something I can't pinpoint, I just try to remind myself, like, this is something I want to do till I die. So if I, you know, if I'm not doing it right now, that's just putting a halt on what I'm trying to do forever. So it's just a constant reminder to continue to work towards, like, what I want to do. Because I literally don't see myself.
Which is the night afro blue. And it employs beautiful girls.